after a year or so where we haven't been able to get together. And this is a film that's been put on by our organisation, Jubilee Australia. It's our first event for about 18 months. So it's really great to see such a great turnout tonight. In fact, there was a discussion about whether to have, this is our first event, I believe, in the eastern suburbs ever. And there was some discussion about whether eastern suburbs will be able to match the inner west in terms of. There was a perception that everyone's just interested in going to the beach and surfing. But I think we've proved them wrong tonight.
Oh, nice.
Exactly, yeah, and screening at night probably helped with that. For those of you who don't know about our organisation, we are a Sydney-based research and advocacy group that shines a spotlight on the negative environmental and human rights impacts that Australian companies and Australian policies have on our region. Or as we like to put it more simply, we like to try and make Australia a better neighbour in our region. If you'd like to find out more about what we do, you can go to our website and or talk to us after the screening. We know a lot of you already, but it's great to see some new faces here tonight as well. In terms of this film and why we're presenting this film, Ophir, it really speaks to a lot of the issues that we at Jubilee work on. It's a beautiful film, as you'll see, and it's as an organisation, we've been working on the issue of mining in Bougainville, the legacy of the Panguna mine, the Australian connections, the Rio Tinto connection, for about 6 or 7 years, and I couldn't imagine a more powerful demonstration of the impact that Australian policy and Australian actors have had on the island of Bougainville. The film is a very interesting exploration in that it weaves together three stories or themes. The first one is the historical theme that explores the colonial mindset of the Australian administration and the Australian company Cosic Rio Tinto, as it was then known, or CRZ, now just Rio Tinto obviously, in developing the mine in the 60s and 70s with the support of the Australian government. Of which PNG was a mandated territory. With the second theme that the film explores is the contemporary perspectives about how Bougainvillians today understand the impact that the mine had, both in terms of the profound environmental effect, but of course in terms of the civil war, which eventuated out of dissatisfaction with the mine. And the third theme looks towards the future as Bougainville wrestles with the then upcoming independence referendum. This film was shot in around 2014-15, that sort of era. As most of you will know, the independence referendum occurred last year and Bougainville resoundingly voted for independence. It's obviously a really personal film for Bougainvillean and Papua New Guinean audiences, but it's an important film for Westerners, especially Australians, because it forces us to, as Australians, to investigate our own complicity in what was the region's most deadly conflict since World War II. It also forces us to ask questions like, what is development for? What is prosperity? And do we as Westerners really have the right to impose our ideas of what these things are onto another culture? A couple more things before we get started, I'd like to do an acknowledgement of country. I'd like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land that we're meeting on, the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation, their leaders past and present, and their continuing contribution to culture. Sovereignty was never ceded, this was and always will be Aboriginal land. Finally, I just want to say a note about the two filmmakers, Olivier Paulet and Alexandre Berman, who are two French filmmakers. Obviously they're in Europe, they can't be here tonight, but this film is really a tribute to their incredible dedication and hard work and their vision. They've got a history of working in PNG and the region, and their previous film credits include the film Canning Paradise, about the tuna industry in the Pacific. You met some of the Jubilee team when you came in. You'll meet more of them. You'll meet them again later when we do the Q&A. You'll also meet Quintamaya Crofts, who's a Bougainvillean former journalist and now advocate for self-determination, and she's going to be part of the Q&A that we'll do after the film. But that's all for me now, and I'll see you again at the Q&A. And thank you again for coming. And now we'll roll the film.